Well, the holidays mean time with family and gift giving, and it could also bring up a whole lot of problems.
So we asked some of you to send in some of your holiday troubles, and we also asked around our station, and we found that there are a lot of holiday dilemmas. So we brought in Let's Talk Live's life coach, Margie Warrell, to answer your questions.
How are you?
Hi there.
I'm great. How are you?
We're good, thank you.
That's
apparently
good.
We don't have any of the holiday dilemmas that some of these people are telling
us about.
You've
got it sorted out. Okay.
Not really. I just don't talk about it.
I'm a master. I get it all figured out.
I make it look like on the surface.
The list is too long. You just weren't sure where to start.
Exactly.
Right,
exactly.
Right.
We have what? We have like a couple people
right,
that emailed
some people
in.
Emailed. And so we're going to start with Caitlin. She emailed in that she is 27 years old and still sitting at the grandkids table for Christmas dinner. Now, she's asked to sit at the grown-up table before, and she's been told she's still a grandkid. She wants out. By the way, the next oldest cousin, 12.
So they have a lot in common there.
Lots to talk about.
It sounds like the family need to have a look at the rules and think about being more flexible. Because I think when you have hard and fast rules like that, whether it's at Christmas time or any time, you know, they don't always work. So, you know, if you're 27 years old and you're sitting with your little 6 and 7 year old cousins, I can understand why she'd be feeling upset.
You know, what we don't have a detail on, Caitlin, is I would like to know if it's actually a small table.
Like a short table for shorter people.
Or a big table, because that would just be a double slap in the face. You're with the 12-year-olds, and you're in the tiny chair.
And she might still have plastic plates and plastic cups. And
no alcohol, maybe, because she's at the kids' table.
And juice boxes.
So Caitlin needs to stand up for herself, is what
you think. I think she does, and I think she needs to say, hey, you know, I'm an adult now, and, you know, would you like this if you were in my shoes? Because my guess is that people, if they think about it, they wouldn't. But, you know, sometimes with even younger children, they get to that point where even they're 12, 13, 14, you know, where do you put them? And I think there comes a point where you need to say, okay, everybody needs to be included. And if there's not enough space on one table, split kids and adults over two, and maybe say for dessert, the adults can sit together and the kids.
Yeah, there's got to be a cutoff point. You're 27. What are they waiting for her to have her own children?
I think a little bit of common sense can go a long way.
And if the family is like keeping hard and fast to that rule, nope, you're a grandkid, you have to sit at the grandkids' table. I mean, is there a way she can protest just by wiggling her way into the grown-ups' table, or just saying, you know what, I'm just going to have Christmas dinner
elbowing
with friends
her
this
way.
Year, you know, other adults.
Yeah. You know what, at 27, you could choose not to have Christmas dinner at all with the family. You know, she's an adult, so, you know, if I was her, I would just say, hey, come on. Let's be fair and reasonable, and
either
you I'm hope that they respond to that.
Right, either I'm with the grown-ups or I'm just not coming.
Stand up. Take a stand. Here's another snitchuation, as I like to call them. We also talked with one of our producers here at the station about holiday gift giving.
Uh-huh.
And here's what Kara had to say. We're actually going to take a listen.
My holiday dilemma is that my father-in-law gives very, very bad gift suggestions for his family members. And my husband and I never know what to get for his father's wife. This year, the suggestion was socks, special sports socks. And we really don't want to get her that. What are some other options?
Oh, well, a life coach to shopping expert.
Yeah, you know, I'm not the shopping expert, but socks do sound a little bit
bland.
Dry.
Mm.
You know, and I think what can be fun sometimes is a gift certificate to a place. You know, so they can go out and choose something. I really enjoy gift certificates because then I get to go and choose what I want.
Exactly. I like that too, but I wonder about it for certain people if it's not as personal.
True.
You see what I'm saying?
True.
Like,
true.
I would love it if, you know, if my sister gives it to me, I can go and get what I want.
Well, you know, and you could always just disregard what he's saying and think, you know what, I'm going to get her what I think she would like.
Right.
And just do the best you can and hope it works. And, you know, if you want to put a gift receipt on it, fine, put a gift receipt on it. But I think, you know, something like socks, if you really don't feel like he has a track record for really bad gift suggestions, I think, you know, stop asking him.
Right. Or maybe there's a way to sniff around for a different idea. You know, call her on the phone and just chat about life and how it's going and see if something comes up.
Yeah, I mean,
be
if
a little detective.
You know what she might be interested in, and you can have a sense of that too. So,
The buck has to stop at the socks.
Or the classic tie.
All right, next up.
All right, now money was also a hot topic for a lot of people.
Mm-hmm. You know, even in families, I think that's where a Kris Kringle kind of thing, it's like, let's say, hey, why don't we all decide we're going to get a gift, you know, for one person, or we'll all do three gifts, you know, for three people, and instead of having to buy for 25 people, because it can become very expensive. The other thing is, you know, you don't have to spend a lot of money to give a great gift. You could make your favorite dish. I bought you in and the team from Let's Talk Live in some almond rocker that I made with my kids.
Thank you.
I made it with my kids
Impressive.
Last weekend. And, you know, it wasn't expensive with a little Christmas dish. Or you could do, you know, you can make up your own gift certificate. Give somebody a voucher to a video rental and say, hey, we're going to do movie nights once a month for the next 12 months.
Thank you for this, by the way. It's beautiful. Yeah. And I think it's much more personal.
Yeah.
Because you made it.
So I think it's about the thought you put into things. They don't have to be expensive. It can be a skill that you have that no one else has, or buying someone a journal and writing an inscription in it. Or, you know, there's lots of things that you can do that aren't expensive that can be really that personal touch.
Another good one, I heard somebody got something like that and it was a voucher for babysitting. Like, you go out with your husband, I'll do this for
you. Free babysitting.
Yeah, free babysitting. That's good stuff.
That's a good one. I heard a friend the other day say also she was going to pick several of her favorite books that she had read over the course of the year, wrap them up in a nice ribbon.
Yeah.
I'd like to share these books with you.
And that can be a lovely, with a really nice inscription in it, that's just a really touching gift. Mm-hmm. And, you know, I've been given gifts over the years that can be, I know of people have spent a lot of money on, and I'm like, I really am not going to use this. You know, what do I do with it? And so think about, what would that person really value? Not what I value, but what would they value?
Come right back into these difficult holiday questions.
The
Margie Warrell stayed around. You're breaking them down for us. So here's another one, and you probably recognize this person. It's one of our segment producers, Whitney Bright, and she's got a question for you.
I guess my holiday dilemma would be if you've just started dating someone and you talk to them about what you're going to do for, you know, exchanging gifts, what if that person doesn't want to do anything at all? This isn't like a monetary thing or a budget thing. It's they don't like the holidays and they don't want to get you a gift.
Ooh, bah humbug.
Ooh. Scrooge.
Somebody's just not into it.
So I'd have to ask Whitney, you know, how nice is this guy? Because this is sounding a bit bah humbug-ish. But, you know, I think sometimes people have a real issue with the holidays because they follow a different tradition. And I think it's really important that it's not dishonoring your own beliefs or traditions. It's respecting somebody else's. Mm-hmm. Right. So I think, you know, Whitney, it'd be helpful to think about, you know, for him to think about, this is important to you. So if he cares about you, therefore, you know, it's okay to go along with your tradition.
Good point.
So I think this isn't about whether he likes the holidays or he doesn't, or he believes in Christmas or he doesn't. That's not the point. The point is it's important to you. And so therefore, if he's being generous, he will just say, hey, it's okay. If this is important to you, let's do it.
And I'll go along with it.
And I'd be kind of coming back at him from that and saying, this is important to me. Right. And you know what? If he's a real
stickler,
wrench just about it. That isn't very generous not to go along with a holiday tradition
she
that's important
so
to you.
Nicely.
Maybe you ought to call this guy. Tell him what you
I
really
don't
think.
Know. I'd be questioning him.
Like, right. Maybe it's not about money, but you know, sometimes people aren't
not forthcoming about money.
Well,
problems.
They're embarrassed, and you got to understand that too.
You know what? And maybe he doesn't know what, and maybe she's thinking he's supposed to be buying. He's thinking he's supposed to buy something really expensive.
A grand
he
gift.
He doesn't believe in that. I'm supposed to get him diamonds or something. You know, it's like no. It could just, you know, like give him some sense of what in my family we, you know, it might be a sweater, it might be a little perfume, it could be something really. So if they're not used to giving gifts, they just might not know, well, what's this about? That this isn't something they've grown up with. So you can educate them.
They feel pressured, maybe.
Well, and maybe she could start by easing him into it. You know, let's set a $20 limit.
Yeah.
Or rather than buying something, let's do something. You know,
exactly.
A dinner
That's a great
or coffee
idea.
Or I'm full of them today.
Great idea, coach. It's my job.
You can use that one. It's free. Don't worry about it.
All right, you got another one, don't you?
Yes, we do. Now, this next one is from a viewer named Joni. She and her husband don't see eye to eye when it comes to Christmas gifts. So here's what she writes. My husband and I are disagreeing on what to get our daughter. I think Barbies are okay, but he doesn't like them. Mm. Our daughter hasn't asked for one, but I think when she sees her friend with them, she'll want one. So should I get a couple just in case?
Ooh.
Hmm.
You know, I think some people have a bit of a, you know, a moral issue or about Barbies, but the fact is that every little girl, well, nearly every little girl I've ever met, including my own daughter, loves Barbies. And yes, you know, Barbie does represent a lot of things that some people don't necessarily like, but she probably will want a Barbie when she sees her friends. And I think that, you know, parents will disagree on lots of things in raising their children. And this is just one thing that parents can disagree on. So, you know, in raising kids, you've got to find compromise all the time. And I think sometimes you have to defer to the other person's point of view, defer to their opinion. She's the mum, she's the girl, she's got a daughter, she thinks Barbies would be great, you know.
But surprising her husband just on Christmas morning and she opened
no,
it, not the way.
I think that they should go into the decision and he, you know, I really think strongly we should do this and he needs to go, you know what, okay, it wouldn't be what I would do, but I will defer to you in this case. You know, and find a compromise. I think like all decisions parents make, there needs to be constant give and take. What's the best thing? Sometimes you go along with something that wouldn't be what you would have done, but you do it because it's teamwork. Raising kids is just as much as it is buying presents at Christmas time.
Right. And this one, it sounds like it's more about, you know, the parents agreeing on the child than it is, you know, do we get her a Barbie or not?
Yeah. I mean, if she's 18 months old, that's one thing. But, you know, assuming she's 5 or 6 or so, you know, it's not unreasonable to get her a Barbie.
All right. The final question today is pretty common. It's from one of our TBD crew members. And here is Connie's question about gifts.
My dilemma is I have a friend who has a birthday on the 27th and I want to get her a Christmas gift on the 25th, and so do I get her one big gift for Christmas and her birthday, or do I have to get her separate gifts for Christmas and her birthday?
So this is basically the question of hit with the double whammy, and I see it on both sides because if I was the person that celebrated Christmas and my birthday was 2 days later, I'd be like, I'm getting cheated out of gifts here.
Yeah, I have a sister whose birthday is the 15th of December, so it's the same thing. I know when she was little, we had to be very careful and mindful to separate them out. But I honestly think, what would your friend value? And as you get older, you might think, you know what, fine, just get me one. I mean, honestly, spare yourself the stress of trying to get two gifts. So I think you could even ask your friend, what would you like? You know, I'm happy to get you two, but would you prefer I just get you one larger thing and put it over to her and see? But otherwise, just think about what would she like? Because I think as we grow up, it becomes less important whether or not
We're more understanding.
It's not such a big deal. You know, and depending on your friend's financial situation, you're like, hey, just get me one, because you don't want to put that extra stress, particularly at Christmas time when we are pulling out our credit cards so often.
Yeah.
On our friend.
And maybe you could just leave that stress on your family or your close friends. You do have to get me two.
You know what?
If you really love me.
You
Mom.
Can always say, hey, why don't you give me a half birthday present on the 27th of June? And
definitely,
like, let's split them up throughout
the year. She said, Mom, give Mom the guilt. Like, it wasn't my fault that I was born on the 27th. That was miserable.
I get a half birthday every year. That's a good way to get it.
But you're so right. I think so many of us are stressed and we want to impress people, or at least feel like part of it is impressing people. If it's, you know, someone that you work with, you want to also give that gift and not seem like you can't give back. You know what I mean? There is an element of that.
Yes. But I think coming back to the reason for the season, it's not to spend money. It is to spread joy. And, you know, spend within your means. There's a lot of people who spend money that they can't afford to spend at this time of year, which isn't doing you any favors. It's not doing them any favors. And so really spending wisely, you can be generous, but don't be foolish. And I think, you know, it is nice to impress people. It's nice to let people know you really care about them. But you can do that all year through, and you don't have to be spending lots of money to do it.
You only hurt yourself in the long run.
Yeah.
You see that credit card bill.
Margie, Warrell, thanks for coming in.
A pleasure.
Good to see you.